All right, getting back to work. So, I wanted to go ahead and explain the description of the Institution of None and All on Facebook. That's a pretty good list of things, kind of like topics maybe that the institution's at least interested in pushing right now. And I'm going to go through them and kind of explain it so that people who may have questions can get them answered by somebody who has knowledge of where they came from. So the first thing is all things and all things as they are. And when we consider things, anything, everything, nothing, something, whatever, when you consider these things, you have to consider things in the context of all things. And all things are as they are. But part of the reason that this becomes a mystical statement is because as human beings, we miss a link here. And what happens is we start to think that, well, what is a thing anyway? We don't know. And it's such a nefarious idea with no real form that we lose track of what a thing even is and what they all have in common. And that is nothing. And nothing is above all of those things. And the actual structure and nature of nothing is not what many people think it is. And so you need to have more respect for nothing. It's still okay to use it as a word that means something which is not. I'm using it as an active term of something which is. And when you have meditated on circles and ellipses and orbits and planets and galaxies and atoms and the nature of reality enough, you will come to the conclusion that a thing is a thing because it is bound to itself. It has a boundary around it which separates it from everything else. That is true for concepts, just as it is true for more corporeal salient material objects such as human beings or buildings or cities or religions. And which brings us to the next, no religion before all religion. There is no true religion. There is no one religion. If there were a true one religion, it would be Buddhism. But Buddhism wouldn't even want to claim that. The Buddha wouldn't have you believe that. And so why I think all of you should be Buddhist and you're all automatically Hindu, there is no religion that is greater than all others. And the idea that some religion is greater than all others is absolutely fallacy and ludicrous, and there's no reason to lock yourself in or limit yourself in this respect. Spirituality is not about cutting yourself off from sources or options. For those of you who have been misled in this, I'm sorry. You need to study more. So then we have all religion above no religion, and that really means the exact same thing. The people who believe that there should be no religion whatsoever have very little understanding of what religion even is and how it serves and functions us as human society. The Western world is deeply, deeply, deeply wounded by the failures of Christianity and the criminal behavior of the Catholic Church. Not to mention the absolute insanity of American Protestant Reformationist evangelical fundamentalist born again Christianity of a general red, white, and blue English Anglo-Saxon stripe. That is out of this world, honestly, in terms of how it relates to the structure of religion for the rest of the globe. But you can't stop because of it. You can't let that thing stop you. You can't fear Buddhists because Christians in the Midwest are crazy. You know what I'm saying? That's not right. So don't do that. And next thing is darkness, nothing. We covered that in the last video. I'm not going to go over primal consciousness again. I'm not going to go over universal intelligence again. Those things both feed into human evolution as they feed into all evolution. That is how evolution happens. It's a conscious cosmic process. It's not random, and it's not at any point, monkeys don't stand up and walk around and begin speaking because it just happens that way. They have to want that. They have to achieve that. They have to set themselves on that path and work toward that. And it's a conscious effort that happens over millions of years. Zero, folks, this is it, okay? This is what things are. Zeros. All things are just little circles going in circles. It doesn't matter what level of cosmic consciousness you're at. It doesn't matter macro, micro. It doesn't matter. It's all little circles going in circles. And my 6 minutes are up, and I'll be back with the rest of that list very shortly. Have a nice day.